Let's talk about Flux, baby. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to install three main versions of Flux for comfy UI, covering which version works best on the lower end systems and which are suited for the higher end systems, and what alternatives are available if you don't have a GPU capable of running the model at all. You might be wondering what Flux is. Stable Diffusion 3 was released and there were a lot of unhappy people in the community. It really did not live up to the hype and the quality that people were expecting. Flux addresses many of the features that Stable Diffusion lacked, offering a more robust solution for image generation and workflow optimization. Flux is a large and resource intensive model, meaning it requires a substantial amount of RAM and storage to run efficiently. In this video, I'm going to be covering the installation for FPH, Schnell and Dev. If you don't have the system requirements to run any of these, it does not matter because you can use the Pro version, which is the top tier enterprise version on API. You can currently access these through the Replicate website, val.ai and mystic.ai. But hopefully I'm going to make it a lot clearer to which version you should be using for your spec and requirements. And just so you know, you can have access to this and all the resources on promptmuse.com. So we're going to start with the FP8 version. This is for lower end systems, so we're looking at 8 to 12 gigabytes of VRAM. It will take about 1 to 3 minutes for each image generation depending on your system. It is quite slow and the image quality is not as good as the full dev version, which we're going to look at in a second. It's one file install and it takes literally 20 seconds to install onto Comfy UI. Then we have the Schnell version. Now the Schnell version is fast, hence the name, but again you're going to compromise on image quality as well as detail. This will run on 8 to 12 gigabytes. I say 8 because I know people running it on 8, but it is pretty slow, so I would say minimum requirement 12 gigabytes really realistically. And then we will look at the full dev version, which is a fantastic version if you've got 12 gigabytes of VRAM or upwards. This will provide you high quality images. It adheres lovely to the prompt. If you select which one you are going to download and use the link in the description just to jump to that section. But whichever version you're going to use, you do need to update your Comfy UI. So I'll show you how to do that very quickly. Open up Comfy UI, go to Manager and click on Update Comfy UI. Once you get the message saying updated successfully, you will need to restart and reboot Comfy UI completely. To do that, just click on Restart and then click on OK to reboot. Okay, with the update sorted, we can now move on to installing Flux. So you just need one file to install for this. Go to the link in my description for the FP8 number 1 and click on download. You will need a Hugging Face account. If you haven't already got one, sign up. Right click on the download hyperlink and click save link as. We're now going to go to the Comfy UI folder in your computer and then we're going to go to models, checkpoints and then save that file there. We're pretty much done. It is that quick. You're now going to load up Comfy UI. Go over to the Comfy UI manager and click on update all. So you will need to restart or reboot your Comfy UI in order for it to install those files in the back end. So make sure you reboot Comfy UI completely. Otherwise, it's not going to work and you're going to get an error. And you will need a workflow. You can get that from my website. So just go onto my website and under number 1, you'll see download JSON workflow. So just download that and in your downloads folder just literally drag and drop that file into your Comfy UI. Alternatively, you can go to load in your Comfy UI manager and load the JSON file from there. Simply click Q prompt to run the image generation. This took approximately 1 minute on my PC to render this image and I've left the same prompt in for you as well. I am running on a 16 gigabyte of RAM PC. We're now going to be installing version 2, which is the Flux Schnell, which means German something. To download this, find the Flux Schnell link in my description and that will take you to the Hugging Face page. If you haven't got an account there already, you need to sign up and then right click on the downloads button and click save link as. Now you'll need to save this in your Comfy UI folder on your computer, so Comfy UI, models and then UNet. Just save that file in there. The next step is to download the encoders. Again, you'll find a link in the description and the number 2. All you need to do here is download the clip_l.safetensors. Just go to the downward arrow, right click, and then save the link into your Comfy UI, models, and then clip. and then in there just save that. And then next file, you just want to download the t5xxl_fp8.safetenders. Again, go to downward arrow, right click on it, save link as, and save that in the same folder. Okay, so this is the last back end file that we need to install. This is the VAY file, so go down in the description and find the link under 2 for the VAY file. Now right click on this and save link as, and as before, just go to comfy UI, models, and VAY, and just save it in there. Okay, done. And then all we need to do is go to the manager and update all. Now you will need to restart comfy UI, so give that a quick restart, and I mean a complete restart, so reboot the whole comfy UI system, and then that will install everything in the back end you will need. So back in comfy UI, you'll need a workflow to go with the Schnell version. There is a JSON workflow on my website available for you to download on the page in the link below. So just download that, and in your downloads folder, just literally drag and drop that file into your comfy UI. Alternatively, you can go to load in your comfy UI manager and load the JSON file from there. Simply click Q prompt to run the image generation. This took approximately 10 seconds to create the image. I am working on a 16 gigabyte VRAM card. So this is the full version, which will give you the highest quality by Black Forest Lab, the creators of the Flux model. Go to number 3 in the description below and download the model from there. You will need to sign into Hugging Face, and if you don't have an account, please register. You will also need to agree to their terms and conditions on the page here. You can then download the full version SafeTenser and right click on download and save link as, and go to your comfy UI folder on your computer and go to models and unit and save that SafeTenders file into there. Next, we need to download the separate clip files. Go again down in the description below and select the clip files from there. You need 2 clip files. You need clip_l.safetenders as well as the t5xxl_fp16.safetenders. So go to the downward arrow next to them and right click that and save link as, and save them in your comfy UI folder under models and then under clip, and save those both in there. And then the last back end file you'll need is the VAE. Go in the description below, download the VAE, and then just right click on the download button and then save link as, and then again go into your comfy UI folder, go into models, and then go into the VAE folder and save in there. If you hop back into comfy UI and go to the manager and click on update all, and then once that's finished, you need to reboot the system. A restart is not enough. You need to reboot comfy UI just to install everything that we've put into the back end. We now need the workflow for the full dev version. So again, go onto my website and you'll see a link there for the JSON. Once you've downloaded that, you simply drag and drop that into the comfy UI. I'm just going to run this prompt, and it took approximately 40 seconds to render on my 16 gigabyte VRAM card. The image result is far richer and more detailed and a heck of a lot nicer than the previous versions. But as I said before, this is a bigger model than all the rest, and of course it's going to give you better results. A great resource for Flux workflows is the GitHub repository from Comfy Anonymous. You can download the original workflows that I used in this tutorial from here. If you found this video useful, please hit the notification bell and give it a thumbs up. If you want to see some tutorials on Forge and Automatic 1111, you know what to do. Just put it in the comments down below. Love seeing what you guys create. I'm at promptmuse on pretty much every platform. So if you want to send me a message or show me what you've created, that would be fantastic. As usual, thank you so much for joining me, and that will do it. Bye-bye.